Herbert Hughes, the 16th of May 1882 to the 1st of May 1937, was an Irish composer, music critic, and a collector and arranger of Irish folk songs. Topic: Biography. Hughes was born and brought up in Belfast, Ireland, but completed his formal music education at the Royal College of Music, London, where he studied with Charles Villiers Stanford and Charles Wood, graduating in 1901. Subsequently, he worked as a music critic, notably for the Daily Telegraph from 1911 to 1932. Described as having an ardent and self-confident manner, Hughes is first heard of in an Irish musical capacity beyond being honorary organist at St. Peter's Church on Antrim Road at the age of 14, collecting traditional airs and transcribing folk songs in North Donegal in August 1903 with his brother Fred, F.J. Bigger, and John Campbell. Dedicated to seeking out and recording such ancient melodies as were yet to be found in the more remote glens and valleys of Ulster, he produced Songs of Ulaid (1904) with Joseph Campbell, illustrated by his brother John and paid for by Bigger. Throughout his career, he collected and arranged hundreds of traditional melodies and published many of them in his own unique arrangements. Three of his best-known works are the celebrated songs, My Laggin Love, She Moved Through the Fair, and Down by the Sally Gardens, which were published as part of his four collections of Irish country songs, his key achievement. These were written in collaborations with the poets Joseph Campbell and Padraic Colum, and Yeats himself. A dispute with Hamilton Harty over copyright on My Laggin Love was pursued on Bigger's advice, but failed. Married to Lillian Florence, known as Mina Meacham and Suzanne McKernan, Herbert had three children: Patrick, known professionally as Spike Hughes, Angela, and Helena. He died in Brighton, England, at the relatively early age of 54. Topic: Music. Hughes had a unique approach to arranging Irish traditional music. He called upon the influence of the French impressionist Claude Debussy in his approach to harmony. Musical art is gradually releasing itself from the tyranny of the tempered scale. And if we examine the work of the modern French school, notably that of M. Claude Debussy, it will be seen that the tendency is to break the bonds of this old slave driver and return to the freedom of primitive scales. He regarded arrangements as an independent art form on an equal level with original composition. Under his, i.e. the arranger's, hands it is definitively transmuted into an art song of its own generation. Hughes's folk song arrangements have been sung all across the English-speaking world. John McCormick and Kathleen Ferrier were the first to record them on gramophone records. An admirer of James Joyce's poetry, Hughes in 1933 edited the Joyce Book, a volume of settings of Joyce's poetry, with 13 pieces by 13 composers including, besides Hughes himself, Arnold Bax, Arnold Bliss, Herbert Howells, John Ireland, and non-British composers such as George Antheil, Edgardo Carducci, and Albert Roussel. The large format, blue cloth covered volume has since become a collector's item. Hughes also composed a limited amount of original chamber music and some scores for the stage, like And So to Bed by John Bernard Fagan, and film. Hughes and John Robert Mansell also created songs for a musical version of Richard Brinsley Sheridan's The Rivals called Rivals, which was staged at the Kingsway Theatre in London in September 1935 by Vladimir Rosing. Topic: Selected works. Topic: Folksong arrangements. Songs of Ulaid, Belfast, 1904. Irish Country Songs, 4 volumes, London, 1909, 1915, 1934, 1936. Historical Songs and Ballads of Ireland, London, 1922. Old Irish Melodies, London, 1931. Topic: Original compositions. Vocal. She Weeps Over Rahun, James Joyce, for voice and piano, London, 1933, in the Joyce book. Choral works such as two Old Testament spirituals, Boreens of Derry, Christmas Time, Dr. Foster Instrumental. Three Impressions for Wind Quintet, N.D. Three Moods for Brass Quartet, N.D. Topic: Selected recordings. The Last Rose of Summer. Best Loved Songs of Ireland, performed by Anne Murray, mezzo, and Graham Johnson, piano, on Hyperion CDA 66627, 1993, reissued as CDH 55210, 2005. Contains The Leprechaun, I Have a Bonnet Trimmed with Blue, A Young Maid Stood in Her Father's Garden, The Next Market Day, The Bard of Armagh, Monday, Tuesday, The Stuttering Lovers, I Will Walk with My Love, The Cork Leg, beside song arrangements by John A. Stevenson, Charles V. Stanford, Benjamin Britten, etc. A Purse of Gold Irish Songs by Herbert Hughes, performed by Eilish Tynan, soprano, and Ian Burnside, piano, on Signum Classics SIG CD 106, 2007. Contains Reynardine, The Fanade Grove, The Leprechaun, When Through Life Unblessed We Rove, Oh, Breath Not His Name, I'm a Decent Good Irish Body, She Weeps Over Rahun, The Magpie's Nest, Johnny Doyle, Cruckhound Finn, Johnny I Hardly Knew Ye, The Garden Mother's Lullaby, You Couldn't Stop a Lover, I Will Walk with My Love, She Moved Thro', The Fair, The Bard of Armagh, The Old Turf Fire, Oh Father, Father, Build Me a Boat, B for Blarney, She Lived Beside the Anner, The Stuttering Lovers, I Know Where I'm Going, A Young Maid Stood in Her Father's Garden, The Spanish Lady, Tigeri Torum Orum. Topic: Bibliography. David Byers. Herbert Hughes, A Centenary Note. In Soundpost 2, 1982, March issue, p. 6. Axel Klein, Die Musik Erlands im 20. Jahrhundert, Hildesheim, Georg Olms Verlag, 1996, ISBN 3-487-10196-3.